What's up, Internet? Current 1776 here with another Battlbox mission for you. I got mission 104 right here. This is the October box. I'm really excited about this box. I'm really excited about October. As I said in the last video, cooler weather's on the way. We've had a little bit of it. We've had a little taste of it every now and then. It really gets me wanting to get outside because, you know, during the summer months where I live anyway, pretty freaking miserable. Item or two in here I've been teasing you guys with a little bit in the past vidges. You may or may not have noticed it, but when I show it to you, some of you are going to be like, yep, been waiting for that. Let's break into the box, shall we? I'm not going to spend any time just jabbering on and all this stuff and everything else. And by the time you watch this video, the emergency system test or whatever would have happened. So hopefully we're not like in the middle of a zombie apocalypse right now. I mean, I don't think that's going to happen. But people are saying, if you're watching this now in zombie land, welcome to the show. Let's get into it. Mission 104. Put the box right there. We'll grab our mission brief. That's in every single box. Pictures in here, got write-ups about the items, et cetera, et cetera, for you to be able to learn more about them, check them out, and see if there's any info in there that I may or may not say in this video. This is also kind of a roadmap for me to try to stay on task because that's something I don't do very well. Start off with the basic. We're gonna go to the advanced, then the pro and the pro plus. If you're new here, Battlbox is a monthly subscription service. We have four levels, basic, advanced, pro, and pro plus. And as you go up in level, you get everything down. So we're gonna start at the basic level, work our way up to pro plus. And the first item is actually a staff recommended item from Shay Parrish. Pretty much all of the procurement of the items kind of leads the team on the procurement side, and she's a freaking rock star. Everybody give Shay a thanks in the comments down here. But Shay's like a sister to me now. Grown to be great friends. She's a great person. She is really in tune with kind of the healthy lifestyle, right? And so she tries out a lot of products, and this is a product that she thoroughly enjoys, and I have thoroughly enjoyed using it. Cause I'm getting ready for a match. I don't know if I've told anybody this, I'm starting to ramble, but there's a point, okay? Follow along with me, will you? I have with a very close friend of mine, I consider him my brother. I think we all have, hopefully you have one ride or die friend in your life, and this guy is definitely that for me. We used to shoot competitions together years ago, rifle competitions, and it's been a long time since we've done it. So we signed up for this match that takes place in January, which is called Mammoth Sniper Challenge. It is a team sniper match where over the course of 2.5-3 days, we're going to have to also ruck with all our gear a total over the weekend of about 35 to 40 miles. So I've been working on my fitness. Hopefully y'all have been able to tell a little bit of change in me over time, over the last several months. Been working on my eating, been working on, you know, lifting weights, and been trying to work on this rucking thing, which I absolutely despise, carrying a lot of weight and walking and jogging long distances. But I gotta do it with this, so I've been preparing for it. By doing so, I need to have something very fitting for hydration, right? I sweat a lot. Even right now, it's like in the mid-lower 80s, I'm starting to sweat in here, okay? This stuff right here is recommended by Shay, and I love it. It's great. It is the Mountain Ops Hydrate. It's a lemonade flavor. So you get, was it 20? Yeah, so there's 20 in here. We'll bust this thing open. But they're individual packets. So hydration's a big deal. Y'all know that. You've seen all my water filtration videos and stuff like that. You also gotta think about electrolytes and things of that nature. This stuff is manufactured in the USA. So that is a plus. I keep packets of this in my vehicle. I keep packets of it with my gym gear. And of course I keep packets of this stuff with me while I've been practicing on my rucks and trying to get my legs to cooperate, not pass out there. So you get 20 packs, you know, your typical like stick type packs, this right here, as you can see. So this stuff is really, really, really good stuff. It tastes great, mixes very well. It's not real granular, like when you mix it up, it's not kind of granular kind of taste or whatever, or texture when you're drinking it. But it's got a lot to offer you, okay? So it says here, it enhanced hydration, cellular fluid balance, stamina, endurance. It's got vitamins and minerals, helps with rapid recovery and muscle recharge. Drop one of these in a bottle of water, mix it up real good, drink it down, and it's gonna help keep you going, okay? And it tastes great. Yeah, some people just, I don't mind drinking just straight water. I've done that for years. But you know, it's nice to have some taste to it. And some people just can't freaking stand drinking just straight water. Like they want to have some flavor or whatever. But there's all kinds of stuff in here. Vitamin A, vitamin C, E, niacin, B6, folate, B12, calcium, magnesium, zinc, sodium for your electrolytes, potassium, coconut water powder, L-thiazine, L-theanine. I don't know that crap. Anyway, we obviously spend our time outdoors a lot. You need to stay hydrated, but you also need to have a little bit of energy. You need to have some muscle recovery, and you definitely need electrolytes in your system. And this is a great packet of 20 for you to get on with that. Get on, yeehaw. Freaking awesome. Of course, they got all sorts of different flavors, but we elected for the lemonade because lemonade's awesome. The second item in the basic box is a book from Field & Stream. It's the Total Camping Manual. I've said this in the past, you know, we try to send out, you know, at least some sort of physical book every year. A lot of us in the prepper community really believe in having a physical library for many reasons, right? Of course, we live in the digital age. You can go on the internet, you can freaking search anything. You can pretty much get, you know, you can get audiobooks, you can get tons of stuff, right? But there's something to be said about having a physical book, okay, and building out your library, simply because without electricity and without certain modern conveniences that we have to be able to get information, if those things are down or if you don't have access to them, books are a great thing to have, to keep in your supply, keep on your coffee table at home, to keep in the bathroom, keep by your bed, or build yourself an actual, you know, area library so you can sit down and read. And I know for me, I tend to, I guess, absorb information a little better through physical books versus the internet. I use the internet probably more than I use books, okay? I'll be completely transparent with you. But I seem to retain information more than when I read books. It's just a convenience thing, right? So I'm myself personally working on a library and actually hope to put it right there on that wall over there. I'll show you that one day when I get that wall finished. I'm planning on putting a bookshelf over there. Very well made. It's a really nice book. Lots of great information in here. You know, the theme in it is total camping, but of course, camping and outdoor survival skills kind of coincide together, right? You can kind of cross-reference a lot of stuff with that. We got things on here on, you know, understanding where to go, understanding how to manage your campsite and things like that. Got gearing up, so there's all kind of information in here about gear. There's information in here with essential skills, putting up an A-frame tarp, you know, how to dry your boots with hot rocks, just tons of like tips and tricks, okay? Cooking, being out with your family, problem solving, things such as that. And it's lots of really good information with that. Absolutely freaking huge amount of great pictures. I'm the guy that likes pictures in his books. Just saying, hey, if I could find me a good survival coloring book, I'd probably be the guy that would very much so like that. Great information in here that can help you kind of just think about things, get stuff into your brain so that when you're experiencing them while you are out, you'll know how to solve the problem or you know how to do some of these things if you are not a very avid outdoors person, outdoorsman. And that's great. These books are also an inspiration, hopefully to help inspire you to get out and do some of this stuff. And obviously a resource, lots of really cool stuff in here, especially with kids, okay? We gotta pass this stuff on to the kids. There's lots of cool stuff in here. It kind of shows you things you can do with the kids out at camp to teach them how to do things and kind of build a great family experience while camping, yeehaw. I'm sweating. I'm freaking sweating. Why do I sweat so bad? Maybe it's all the electrolytes. You're leaking electrolytes. So the next item in the basic box is a really cool item. It's called the Tree Free Fire. I know for me, there's been times where I've been places where I wish I had me a little campfire, you know? I mean, even like when I have to travel and I'm staying at a hotel or something that may have like a little balcony or a little, I guess that's what it's considered, a little balcony or whatever, or a little patio type deal just outside your room. You're like, man, I wish I'd have me a little ambiance here, man. Have me a little campfire right there. campfire and you pack. This thing is great. It's great at home. If you're in an urban setting and you just want to sit out on your front porch or whatever and have you a cool little fire going, and you know, you're in a setting where you just can't freaking put a fire pit out in your freaking yard, this thing is great. If you go to certain camping areas or certain times of year to some places that restrict you building like legit fires outside of like a device or something like that, this right here, you can get that campfire vibe without starting a huge campfire and having a mess to clean up and all that. What's also cool about this is it's multi-use. So you can snuff this thing out, carry it with you, and reuse it over and over and over again until eventually it burns out, but takes a while. So this is made from all natural, eco-friendly, hand-dipped soy wax and peat briquettes. Doesn't produce any real bad or toxic unwanted smoke, sparks, or odors, and it can provide up to an 8-inch tall flame and last 3 to 5 hours of continuous burn time. There's no mess, there's no fuss, none of that stuff, and you can cook over this if need be. So let's get this bad boy lit. As you can see here, it's just got these little, these foil briquette type deals in here. And this is safe to sit on your patio furniture. Just, I mean, no worries. This thing right here is good to go and safe. And it's made 100% here in the US. And you can start this with a regular lighter or anything like that, but I had this on my gun bench back there, so. But yeah, you can set that out on the evening with your girl, with your wife, with your kids, with your buddy, if you're into that. Have you a cold one or whatever, have yourself a little campfire going right there on a patio, take it with you to friends' homes, yada, yada, yada. Take it with you camping when you have a restriction and you can't use natural materials and all that fun stuff. And then when you've had enough, oh, you can cook your s'mores over it, whatever you want to do. You want to put a little thing, a little grate over here and boil some water or whatever, you can do all that with this. It's freaking great. Got your little instruction piece of paper in here. Obviously put that aside so it don't catch fire. But yeah, the thing's really cool. It's sleek, it's portable, and it's reusable. And proudly made from the fine folks in Maine, USA. Just snuff it out like that, let it cool down, and put it back in your pack. You're ready to rock and roll next time you want yourself a little campfire. So now it's time for the advanced box. And I have 100% been teasing you guys with this item right here in past videos. Completely honest with you. You gotta pay attention to my videos. I tend to sneak things in there that may interest you that we may be putting in future battle boxes, okay? It may take a little bit. It might be the next box. It might be 2 boxes away. It might be 3 boxes away. Heck, there's times when we're 4, 5, 6 boxes away because we got to plan out that far. But this item right here has been a lot of buzz about, and now I can finally let the freaking cat out of the bag and show you from Uberleben the Kessel stainless pot. I love this thing. I love Uberleben. Uberleben makes really cool products, and you know, they kind of have that outdoorsy bushcraft kind of vibe and all going, and this thing is great. Excellent addition to your bushcraft kit, camping kit, whatever. You can use it for anything. You can use it in the house. So as you can see here, it's got this smexy little canvas, wax canvas cover here. You open that dude up and you got your Kessel pot. I love anything wax canvas. I got an addiction to wax canvas for whatever reason. So with this 304 stainless pot here, you got your top that has strainer holes here on the front. It's got a genuine wood handle right there. So you got a top, here is your handle, and it's kind of unique how this handle works. So you got here this little screw that you screw off, and the handle actually goes over the pot like this. So you put it right there, you screw that dude back in, lock it down, and you hold the pot, you know, pick the pot up just like that, pour it, etc., etc. Really, really cool item. I've loved using mine. It's a great thing in camp, great for soups and rehydrating foods, of course, boiling water for purification, all the things, right? And it's just, it's cool. It's stylish. It will last forever. Obviously, you have to take care of it. But you can put it directly on coals. You can put it over the fire, yada, yada, yada. You can hang it right there from the handle, and it'll balance itself very well when it's got something inside of it. It's completely polished inside and out. I mean, it's a very freaking, you can see yourself in it. It's like a freaking mirror. I mean, it's freaking great. It's a great pot. You need to have good, durable, you know, cooking type utensils when you're going out camping or bushcrafting or whatever, and definitely you need containers, right? What's really cool about this too is if you have like a little camp stove or whatever. Do I have the, I feel like I had one somewhere. Stand by. I'm back. There I go for preparation, right? So if you got yourself a fuel canister like this, what's great about it is, not this thing, this thing's gonna be too big to fit in there, but you know, they got the small ones that'll fit down in there just fine to put in here, so you kind of get it all together, right? It's a great thing to keep items inside of this and then put it in here and kind of have a complete kit or whatever. Put your spices in here, your little containers of spices or sauces or ingredients and things like that. And the other thing that's cool about it is, like this, if, obviously I use this for my pot all the time, but this would be a great thing to use to keep tinder in, little fire kits and stuff like that, if you don't want to keep your pot inside of here. And this is also kind of a little bit newer, improved version from the earlier Kessel pots. Just some slight modifications. They changed the spout just a little bit, so it's a little bit better for pouring. The original Kessels, I don't believe, had the weep holes or the strainer holes, vent holes in them. So they got the vent holes in this one. And then the area that the handle attaches to is machined a little bit different to allow it to kind of lock down better, and it doesn't have a whole lot of side-to-side slop. But great little pot right here. Just toss your handle on the inside, put your nut back on, put whatever you want down in there, because that is space you can use for storage, and just drop it back into your deal right there. Zip it up and boom, you got yourself a very nice stainless pot right there for cooking. Some people have been talking about it, and now you got one. This is also a member recommended item. So Jeff C. from Midlothian, Virginia recommended this a while back. Thank you, sir, for the recommendation as one of our loyal subscribers. And there you go. There's your Überleben Kessel. Yeehaw. So now it's time for the Pro Box. The Pro Box this month is also a member recommended item from Jeff B. So we had a Jeff C recommend this. So Jeff B is from Bayside, New Brunswick. And this is a two-part item, okay? Well, not two-part, there's two items in this go together. In the Pro Box, we got the Hybrid Light Atlas 600 Lantern, and we also have the Journey 700 Flashlight from Hybrid Light. Look, Hybrid Light is freaking awesome. When it comes to the solar lighting and solar power bank kind of combo game, Hybrid Light's freaking good. This cat right here is freaking bright. If you can get it up high, it's good. You don't want it eye level. You want it below your eye level, or you want it higher than your eye level, because it'll blind the freaking crap out of you. But a great lantern right here, and an equally great little flashlight right here, which is perfect for in your vehicle. I freaking love this in my glove box. Let me put you guys over here. I got mine in the mystery spot down here, so I don't have to open up them products right there. Where are they at? So the first thing we're gonna look at is the Atlas 600 lantern right here. Check this thing out, man. So on the top here, we obviously have our solar panel. This thing soaks up the freaking sun and charges this dude up very, very well. It's very robust. I've kept this, I got those decked storage boxes in the bed of my truck, and I keep this in there, and it, you know, rolls around and bounces around quite a bit. You know, I mean, I'm not easy on it, and it looks practically brand new, very durable. I mean, you could freaking probably throw this thing across the room. Well, I'm pretty sure you can throw it across the room and not have an issue with it. Very simple to use. You just press the button. Okay. So it has a really cool design. I hope you guys can see this. Let me turn the light off. Maybe you can see it better with that light off. But it's got like this reflective cone. It's like a tornado coming up through the middle of this thing. The lights are actually at the bottom. Freaking goes up that cone and reflects off, and it puts out the light, man. I mean, it absolutely puts out the light. So you got a low, a medium, a high, and if you double tap it, it will blink like so. It's freaking bright. Very rarely do I use it on the highest setting. It's pretty freaking ridiculous. So of course, being called the Atlas 600, maximum output is 600 lumens. So it goes from 25 at the lowest setting up to 600, and it will blind you. It's also got a 4,000 milliamp hour lithium battery in here that you can use to charge other devices. So we got two outputs here, USB, and then you've got your input for charging if you want to charge it using AC power. And of course, you can charge it by using the solar panel on top. Full charge provide you about 100 hours of light use. Obviously, using it as a battery bank to charge something else, that's going to be subject to what you're charging. And the other cool thing about this dude is it floats. It will absolutely float. So if you're into fishing, if you want to hang a little light up on your boat or whatever, if you're out, you know, fishing or whatever, which I need to get back into doing. I used to love going crappie fishing at night, and we would always hang a little lantern up on the boat. If it gets in the water, it's going to float. It's waterproof, yada, yada, yada. So awesome lantern right here. And then we got the Journey 700 flashlight. This has become one of my favorite regular use flashlights right here. I keep this in my truck. I've never hooked it up to USB power to charge it. Oftentimes when I use it, I'm bad about not putting it back in my glove box. So sometimes it's just sitting on the seat, or I'll toss it up on the dash so it's getting sunlight pretty much all the time during the day. It freaking works. It's like the perfect size. And being that it's called the Journey 700, obviously maximum output is 700 lumens. Oh, I don't think I showed you this. Both of them come with a charging cable. Obviously, this guy right here is just, I don't know, man, it's like a workhorse. It's kind of got that kind of rubberized outer kind of feel to it. Very durable. I use it all the time. Like, I'm constantly having to go out. So like my critter pen's a little ways from the house. Oftentimes I'll walk by my truck to go out there at night. If I hear something or something happens, there's always something freaking going on. I can just quickly stop by my truck, grab this flashlight. It's lightweight. It's got a lithium ion battery in it, and it will also charge other devices as well. So you screw the back off, and you've got a USB here for output. And then of course you got your charging port here if you want to use this dude right here for faster charging. So this one has a 2500 milliamp hour lithium ion battery. Obviously it's smaller than this one. It's got a little bit smaller battery. You can charge phones and other devices with it as well. This one you've got a low setting and a high setting. There's no medium, so it just goes low to high. Here on the top is your solar panel. So hybrid light claims, and of course I haven't been able to test this because I haven't had them this long, but these batteries will last 7 years. Like, you can charge this thing, put away, forget about it for 7 years, and you should be good to go. Handle obviously multiple chargings. Those lithium batteries, they don't like dwindle out, and the output, like, so the output don't go down, so your light starts getting dimmer, goes out. It just goes until it can't put out 100% output anymore, and it just goes out. And then you obviously need to charge it again. You got your Journey 700 right there, and your Atlas 600, both of which were recommended by Jeff B. from New Brunswick. Bayside, New Brunswick, yeehaw. If you spend much time outdoors, you need good lighting. This is all there is to it. I don't know about you, but I can't see well in the dark. The Lord didn't bless me with night vision. Those have been great, and I've thoroughly enjoyed them. So now it's time for the Pro Plus. The Pro Plus box. So this item is recommended by Michael O. from Morris Plains, New Jersey. And he is a Holtzman's fan. So let's have a look at the Holtzman clip point folding pocket knife in this here box right here. Holtzman does a great job of his presentation for sure. So you open this up, we've got ourselves a couple pieces of paper here, a flyer and a card. And on the flyer is a 25% discount for our subscribers. So he's got a freaking metric ton of different style knives. Fixed blades all the way down to little neck knives. 25% off is a big deal. I'm sure you're gonna find something there that you like. So we've got a little soft cloth right here. And right here we got an extra clip. It says this clip is not as sturdy as the one on your knife, but it is a little bit smaller profile. If you want to change to a little bit smaller profile, clip provides that and the tools and hardware to do so. And as you can see here in the box, we've got a sharpening stone, the knife itself, and a carrying case, or a case to keep it in if you want to make your kids and wife keep their grubby hands off your nice Holtzman knife. All right, so let's take a look at this nice knife right here. Again, this is the Holtzman clip point folding pocket knife. Let's open it up. Boom. How about that? That is a good looking knife right there. Man, it's robust. It feels very, very just tough. I guess it feels tough. It's a decent sized knife. So overall, it's about 8.5 inches long. We've got gray G10 scales with red liner. You can see there. And then it's got, obviously, it's a liner lock design here. Got your pocket clip here on the back, lanyard hole, and of course, you can see the clip point blade right there. It is D2 steel, and it comes in at around just shy of 3.5 inches. It's like 3.58 inches or something like that. Got a nice thumb stud there for opening, if you want to use the thumb stud. And here on the back, you got your little flippy thing for your flippy finger. You can just flip that dude open just like that. So the pivot here is ceramic ball bearing. It is very smooth, very easy to open with the flipper or with the thumb studs here. And it's ambidextrous thumb stud. So if you're left-handed, you have the stud so you can open it with your left hand as well. I'm not going to attempt that. I am not left-handed. My left hand is almost completely useless. And I would probably fling this thing into the camera and break the camera if I tried doing it with my left hand. So we'll just do it with my right hand. What a nice knife. I like the texture in the scales here. I really like the H right here in the middle. It really gives it a little punch on that gray G10. And the red, the contrast with the red, gray, and the black, man, it just, that's a sexy knife. So also with the knife, you get, like I said earlier, you get this little case so that you can keep your knife in there when you're not using it, when you're not currently using it as your carry. And then you've got a sharpening stone. Holtzman's really good about having the accessories to go along with their blades, which I kind of like. For instance, like you get a fixed blade from them 99 times out of 100. You know, his designs have a ferrocerium rod included in it, a really nice sheath, things like that to complement the knife. Did the same with this, with the case here. And then you've got this sharpening stone, which is a 400 grit on one half and 1,000 on the other, so you can keep that blade tip top shape. Okay, and don't forget, like I've said 1,000 times, sometimes you just need a good stropping. Just get a leather belt, or if you got a strop, most knives you just need to run it a few times on some leather and she's right back to where it needs to be. But if you need to really remove some metal, get down, reprofile, yada yada yada, you've got a way to do that with this here sharpening stone. So that is your Pro Plus for Mission 104, the Holtzman Clip Point Folding Pocket Knife. Yeehaw. With the 25% off coupon right here. So when you get your box, you open it up, be sure you check out that coupon. I'm sure you want to find something on his website you're going to want, I promise you. So that's Mission 104 Battlbox, folks. That's hot right there. I can feel the heat coming. You definitely cook over that. Wow. Really cool box this month to get you going for the outdoors here this fall and going into the holiday season. A lot of really cool items in here, many of which were recommended items from our great subscribers of Battlbox. So quick recap, we've got the Mountain Ops Hydrate sticks right here. There's 20 of them in this pack. Lemonade is freaking great. One of the best additives to water that I've used in quite some time. A lot of them out there don't completely dissolve very well. They're kind of gritty or whatever when you're drinking them. This stuff dissolves very well, and I really feel hydrated and replenished, especially since I've been doing some rucking and sweating my badonkadonk off. It has been a freaking godsend to have that stuff, and thank you to Shay for recommending that. We've got the Total Camping Manual here from Field & Stream. awesome book to add to your library. Great conversation piece to have sitting on your coffee table at home. And it's a great read. Lots of really cool tips and tricks in there and some things that you may not have thought of before. And also includes a lot of stuff in there. If you've got kids, get them outdoors and help get them excited about putting the phone down and spending some time in the great outdoors. And then as you can see here, burning away, we've got a tree-free fire, made in the USA, completely sourced in the USA, and it's a great item. It's freaking great. Anytime that you want to have yourself just that little campfire feel going on, whether you're on a patio or you're visiting or whatever, or, you know, all the things where it could keep you from having one, you can literally have one in your pack and just break that thing out, sit it on a table, sit it on the patio, sit it on the deck, whatever. Light them up and you've got several hours of soothing little campfire. And it's reusable, so if you only burn it for an hour or so, make you a couple s'mores or whatever, you cook something over it, you just snuff it out with the lid, relight it next time, and keep going until you run out. And then when you're done, you have got a freaking awesome tin to keep tinder in, to make char cloth with, to put survival gear in, whatever. I mean, that's a massive tin right there, and it will really come in handy once you use up the tree-free fire right there. I dig that thing. It's freaking great. And as you can see, it burns very well, and it burns hot. I can feel the heat on my face right there for sure. Then we've got recommended item right here from a member. These two lights here from Hybrid Light. Like I said earlier, Hybrid Light is really top of the game when it comes to lighting devices that also can charge other devices and also can be charged with solar. These two guys right here are great. So we got the Atlas 600 lantern right here that's got two outputs for charging other devices. And then we've got the little handheld flashlight right here, which is one of my favorites right now. And this is the Journey 700. 600 lumens, 700 lumens, excellent freaking design. Floats, durable, beat the crap out of them. They're going to keep going. And lithium ion, iron phosphate batteries are amazing. And then another member recommended item, which I thoroughly love, and I've been teasing you guys with for several months, is the Überleben Kessel Pot right there. Wax canvas carrying case, kind of updated design, a little bit better spout. It's got the whole holes in the lid, and the handle connection has been redesigned a little bit. So this is the newest version out right now, and it is absolutely great. And then last but not least, of course, the Holtzman clip point folder. Great knife, great company, awesome designs, and attention to detail. That knife, go over it with a fine tooth comb. It's built very well, very good materials, great thought process on the color designs and things like that. I freaking love it. And you get your carrying case, and you get a sharpening stone to go along with the package. They knock it out of the park from packaging, the customer experience opening the box, really good, and I really enjoy having Holtzman in the box. And that is the Pro Plus for Mission 104. Yeehaw. As always, I appreciate you guys watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you enjoy this month's mission. If you are a subscriber and you have it, or it is on the way to you currently, really looking forward to seeing you guys out in the field using this stuff. Get outside, folks. It's time to get outside. It's cooling off. No excuses. Get out there, work on your skills, have fun with your friends and family, work on your fitness. Get out there, you know, keep me in mind. Put a 70-pound pack on your back and go for a 4 or 5 hour ruck with some mountain ops in your water vessel and suffer with me. Be sure to like and comment down below, share with your friends. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon. Really looking forward to next month's box as well. I'm working on getting that card put together now. It's going to be freaking awesome. Holidays are coming, folks, so be on the lookout for a lot of cool stuff coming along for holiday purposes and things like that if you're looking forward to gifting to friends and family and things such as that as well. I love you. I mean it. I'll see you next month, November, Mission 105. Yeehaw.